In March 2020, the Parliament of Uganda passed the National Health Insurance Scheme Bill, a policy initiative aimed at achieving universal health coverage. However, this was bounced back to the Ministry of Health, needing to meet stakeholders' interests. The ultimate goal for the universal health coverage is to improve health outcomes by expanding access to essential healthcare services for all people in need and by ensuring that the people who seek access to healthcare services do not encounter excessive or undue financial hardship. Speaking during the 7th Doctors' Conference today, Health Minister Dr. Jane Ruth Acheng revealed that the bill is almost ready and once passed, all Ugandans, irrespective of their age, social or economic status, will be required to pay 15,000 shillings per year.
As per now, our starting figure could be about 15,000 from all of you per month. Is that not affordable? And then the indigents, initially, we are looking at 15,000 per year so that your grandmother in the village can afford 15,000 per year. However, remember, dependents below 18 years have to be paid for. So the more other children you have, the more you will pay.
Recently, this bill had been faulted by stakeholders as they feared it would compel employers to deduct at least 4% from employees' salaries. However, Acheng dispelled these fears.
There will be no employer contributions, as this was perceived as overburdening the private sector employer. Dr. Bashasha, that originally was an eyesore, you will recall. Contributions will be segmented according to income groups to maintain the principle of solidarity and affordability and will not be a percentage of the salary.
Dr. Edith Naku, the president of the Uganda Medical Association, says once enacted, the National Health Insurance Scheme Bill will offer great relief to Uganda's health predicaments. She says with the current situation, only economically able Ugandans can access quality medical care. But once this bill comes into force, even the poor will access health care.
Our population is growing, and it's very clear that the government cannot bear every single expense of health. So I think this is a more and more coming down to reality of what is really needed in health. And I think we need to add to that. We shouldn't just stop on the National Health Insurance Policy because it will give only basic care.
Currently in the East African region, Uganda is the only country without a national health insurance scheme, and this has affected the provision of basic health services for the citizens. According to Acheng, the government is already working out modalities to achieve the universal health coverage.
Strengthening community-led interventions through programs that build capacity of community health workforce. And when I talk about community health workforce, we are looking at community health extension workers, the village health teams, and many others, because these people matter. They are our link. All events start in the communities and end in the communities.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.
10-15 minutes. So quickly.